modern humans, Homo sapiens sapiens. Neanderthals dominated the world for 130,000 years. Roughly 300,000 years ago, the old world was occupied by a morphologically diverse group of hominoids, any primate of the family Hominidae. In North America, Africa, and the Middle East, there were Homo sapiens. In Asia, Homo erectus. And in Europe, Homo neanderthalensis. By 130,000 years ago, Neanderthals had all become so anatomically distinct that they were classified as a separate species, Homo neanderthalensis. Then, approximately 50,000 to 60,000 years ago, Cro-Magnons, our ancestors, suddenly appeared on this planet. Instead of living cooperatively with Neanderthals, we annihilated them globally within 25 to 30,000 years. To date, no definite Neanderthal specimens newer than 25,000 years ago have ever been found. However, that does not mean that Neanderthals are necessarily extinct. In fact, there is every possibility that what we identify as Yeti and Bigfoot today are actually Neanderthal survivors, and there is overwhelming physical evidence to suggest that is indeed what they are. In 1999, when the skeleton of a child was unearthed in Lapido, Portugal, evolutionists celebrated wildly. Dated to around 25,000 years ago, the remains showed a mixture of Neanderthal and modern features, suggesting it may be a hybrid, possibly even a proverbial missing link. But small fragments of DNA extracted from three different specimens of the child revealed that it was not closely related to any present-day human populations. All evidence continues to point to the fact that our arrival on Earth was very sudden, and that we are radically different from all native life forms that had ever existed here. The global paleoanthropological and archaeological picture changed dramatically with the sudden and unexpected appearance of Homo sapiens sapiens, Cro-Magnon or modern man. The exile of Cro-Magnons onto the prison planet caused a rough and dramatic change in subsistence patterns. How we gathered food, tools, and symbolic expression, cultures, worldwide. This stunning change in cultural adaptation was not merely a quantitative one, but one that represented a significant departure from all earlier humanoid and hominoid behavior, reflecting a major qualitative transformation. It was literally a creative explosion which exhibited technological ingenuity, social formations, and ideological complexity never before seen on Earth. Early Cro-Magnons were not only anatomically modern, they were intellectually and behaviorally modern. The exile of humans on Earth placed Neanderthals in direct competition with our ancestors for resources. Though the Neanderthals were larger, stronger, faster, and possessed larger brains than Cro-Magnons, it was a competition that the Neanderthals lost. There was much scientific debate as to whether it was climatic change or Cro-Magnon's sudden appearance that resulted in the demise of the Neanderthals. Studies have since concluded that it was competition with our ancestors, and not the climate, that resulted in Neanderthal extermination. It is also why human and Neanderthal bones are sometimes found together in ancient gravesites. While there has been a great deal of effort by evolutionists in the last century to construct an evolutionary link between Neanderthals and Cro-Magnons, none has ever been proven to be accurate or true. In fact, several of the attempts were actually scientifically proven to be intentional frauds, and the rest were revealed to be nothing more than wild speculation. The oldest prehistoric cave drawings and paintings, petroglyphs and other forms of stone art are estimated to be from 20 to 25,000 years ago. Many of the academic community have inaccurately portrayed the early artists as Neanderthal man. The Neanderthals were virtually exterminated by our Cro-Magnon ancestors thousands of years earlier. Despite incredible efforts and acts of deception to prove otherwise, Neanderthals are not the ancestors of modern humans. DNA study concludes modern humans do not have Neanderthal ancestors in their family tree. The DNA extracted from the ribs of a Neanderthal infant buried in southern Russia 29,000 years ago was found to be too distinct from modern human DNA to be related. There wasn't much between Neanderthals and modern humans, said William Goodwin of the University of Glasgow, UK. Though they coexisted, we can't find any evidence of genetic material being passed from Neanderthals to modern humans. The work published in the journal Nature contradicts evidence from ancient remains of a child found in Portugal, which was later proven wrong. The bones from the Neanderthal infant were very well preserved, and the child must have been among the last of the Neanderthals as they died out about 30,000 years ago. Research by Dr. Goodwin, along with Swedish and Russian colleagues, agrees with the findings of the first analysis of Neanderthal DNA in 1997. That study of DNA, taken from the first Neanderthal skeleton found in the Fellhofer cave in Germany in 1856, supports the theory that modern humans replaced Neanderthals. According to Dr. Good, the DNA sequence from the infant was very similar to the specimen from the Fellhofer cave, proving that there was little diversity among Neanderthals. If they had been very diverse at the DNA level, they could have encompassed modern humans. The fact that these two Neanderthals are closely related, and not related to modern humans, implies that they don't have the diversity to encompass a modern human gene pool, said Dr. Goodwin. DNA comparisons also show that different ethnic groups cannot be genetically identified. There is no race gene in us, nor do we have any direct genetic links to Neanderthals. In a commentary on the research in Nature, Matthias Haus of the Swiss Institute for Experimental Cancer Research said that two studies provide the most reliable proof so far of the authenticity of ancient DNA sequences. The similar features of the two samples argues against the idea that modern Europeans are at least partly of Neanderthal origin, he said. Another study by a group of geneticists, coordinated by Guido Barbujani and David Carr Mayi of the Universities of Toronto and Florence, showed that a Cro-Magnoid individual who lived in southern Italy 28,000 years ago was a modern European, genetically as well as anatomically. The Cro-Magnoid people briefly coexisted in Europe with other humanoids, the Neanderthals, whose anatomy and DNA were clearly different from ours. However, obtaining a reliable sequence of Cro-Magnoid DNA was technically challenging. The risk in the study of ancient individuals is to attribute to the fossil specimen the DNA left there by archaeologists or biologists who manipulated it, Barbujani says. To avoid that, we followed all phases of the retrieval of the fossil bones and typed the DNA sequences of all people who had any contact with them. The researchers wrote in the newly published paper, the Paglexite 23 individual carried a DNA sequence that is still common in Europe, and which radically differs from those of the almost contemporary Neanderthals, demonstrating genealogical continuity across 28,000 years, from Cro-Magnoid to modern Europeans. The results demonstrate for the first time that the anatomical differences between Neanderthals and Cro-Magnoids were associated with clear genetic differences. The Neanderthals, who lived at the top of Earth's food chain for nearly 300,000 years, were not the ancestors of modern humans. We suddenly appeared from somewhere about 50,000 to 60,000 years ago. It has been proven that our intelligence is not the result of evolution as we have been led to believe, but rather is the direct result of genetic memory.